In this Weebly tutorial for beginners, I'm going to show you how you can build a website from scratch as a complete beginner in about 20 minutes. So if you're interested in building your own website for free by using Weebly, this is going to be a great video for you because I'm going to show you step by step how you can create your own website. And let's just get started right away. All right, so you want to go to Weebly. So once you're here, you can click on the Create Your Account button right there. And this will help you build a professional website that grows with your business. Now, before I click right here and show you step by step how you can set up your website, I want to show you some of the features and pricing of Weebly. So as you know, there's a free plan available, so you can do this entirely for free if you want to, but you can also go with paid plans if you need to. So there's the free plan, which will cost you €0 or $0, of course. Then there's a plan that will cost you $5 a month, $10 a month, and then $20 a month as well. Now, please keep in mind that this is when you pay annually, so the prices may differ if you're not gonna do that. Now, these plans also come with credit, so it comes with a free domain, and this one comes with a free domain as well, and you will get $100 of Google Ads credit. So if you're running ads on Google, that's always great. Now, if we scroll down, we can take a look at some of these site features. So this comes with 500 MB storage, a domain with Weebly branding. This comes with a custom domain that you can connect. So you can find all the features on here. I'm not gonna go over all of these because there are a ton of features and that might be a bit boring. So let's go back to the homepage and let's show you how you can set up an actual website. So what you wanna do, guys, is simply click on Get Started, and that will then pretty much go to the sign up process. If you don't have an account yet, you wanna sign up. So what I'm gonna do is sign up right now. So type in your name, then pretty much type in your email as well. I'll also do that, just like that. A password, then select your country. So I'm in the Netherlands. Let's see if that shows up. There we go. And click sign up for free. Now by doing that, you've just created your Weebly account and you're ready to sign up and create your own website. So they're gonna ask you what kind of website you would like to create. They'll provide you with the right tools to get started. So you can go with I just need a website, or you can go with I need a website with an online store. So if you're planning on selling products, you wanna go with this option. If you just wanna build a website, just click right here and then you should be fine. Now, this is what I like about Weebly, especially if you're a beginner, because you can go with a theme that's already built. Like all of these are templates that you can choose. You can then customize them and you've just created your website. All right, so what you can do is you can filter on these different categories. So we've got business, we've got portfolio, personal, event, blog, coming soon, and others as well. So what I recommend doing is simply clicking on the category that fits for you, and then you go with a template that you like. So for now, I'll be going with a blog, and I'll be going with this template. This one looks pretty cool. So what you then do is you click on it, and you can then preview the theme to check if you actually want to use it. So let's check this out, guys. If we scroll down, we can see what it looks like. Looks pretty cool to me. So what you can then do is click on Start Editing in the top right corner. If you, however, don't want to use it, you simply click on the cross in the top left, and you then choose another theme. But I'm gonna click on Start Editing because I like this and I wanna use this for my website. And there we go. So right now we're in the Weebly Website Builder. This is where we can build our website. So as of right now, this is our template and this is what it looks like. Now you can see that we don't have any blog posts yet, which is of course correct because we only just created this, but we can now start customizing our website. So if we take a look in the top right corner, we can see the website menu. So if you click on these like menus, you'll see the pages that then show up. So you can see there's no info on this page yet, but we can start customizing it. So if I just go back to blog, we can start customizing it. So basically how this works is that all of this is drag and drop editing. So you can see all features here in the menu bar, and you can pretty much click on your website and you can then customize it. That's why I said that this is great for beginners because it's just drag and drop, it's no coding. So for example, if you want to change the header or an image on your website, you click on it, you click edit background, you click replace right there. You can then upload a photo from your PC, or you can search, or you can even go with an image URL. So I'll upload a picture from my PC. we'll go to my downloads. There's probably a lot of different stuff on here for YouTube videos and other stuff as well. But let's say that I want to go with this as my banner, like header. I then click on it. It's then going to upload and I can then select that. Now you can also go with all of these images that are already included on the Weebly website builder. So you can find all of these that you can also use, but I'll just be uploading my own image. Now once this is done, I'm going to click select. Let's see if it already works. And there we go, upload complete. So right now this is our header. Looks pretty cool to me. So what you can do, is preview it, and you can also zoom if you want to. So if, as you can see right there, you can zoom this, but this is fine. You can also blur this. It's then gonna process. So let me just do it like 20% or so. Let's do 10, and then you can darken it if you want to. Let's also do 10%. And then once you're done customizing this, all you need to do is click on the green save button in the top right corner. And you'll then go back to the website editor where you can see that the header on your website has actually changed. So what you can do next is customize the text. So for example, if I want this to say how to digital, you simply select it and you then type in whatever you want to use. So right there, I can then say welcome to, and it now says welcome to how to digital on my banner. And that's how you can do that. Now you have the option to customize the fonts and the color as well. So maybe you want this to be blue. You then simply select blue and there you go. That's how it works. So all of this is pretty simple editing. You just click, you change it, and then you're good to go. Now you can make this smaller and bigger if you want to, just like that. And you can see right there. Now you can also add a link. So if you click right there, you can add a website URL. You can link it to a different page. You can add a phone number, files, blog post, and a product page as well. So if you want people to be able to click on like how to digital in this case, and then go to a different page, you can do that by clicking right here and then linking a page. That's how you can do that. Now, apart from customizing stuff, you can also add stuff in here. You can do that by using the features like the menu bar here on the left side. For example, if you want to add an image, what you do is you select it, you then pretty much drag it wherever you want to add it, and then you're good to go. So you place it right there, for example. There you go. You click upload image. You then select one. Maybe we'll go with this one right there. This is just going to be random, guys, for the sake of this tutorial, by the way. But you'll then see how it works. So it's going to upload and it will show up right here. So the entire process is drag and drop editing. So you simply select a feature that you want to add to your website. Now that could be a product, that could be like a blog feed, right? Maybe you want to add some blog feed. You then simply swipe that in there and then you're good to go. Let's see, blog offer, where did I see that? Right there, you can drag it. And that's pretty much how this works. Now you can also go into the settings, and this is your website settings, which you can also find on the layout at the top. So if you click right there, you can go to general settings. So you can customize the title of your site. For example, you might want to call this how to digital. That's how you can do that. You can choose a category. You can enable the SSL. You can upload a favicon. So maybe you want to change this to your logo so that the icon right here, for example, right there, will show up as your logo. And for that, you do need a different plan. So you cannot do that with the free plan, unfortunately. But if you're looking to upgrade, then that's another feature that comes with it. You can enter a site password. This is pretty much where you can change all settings for your website. Now, let's say that you want to customize pages. You simply go to pages. Then on the left side, you'll find it. You can also change the names. So maybe I want to have a page with YouTube channel. You then simply type YouTube channel, just like that. And that will then work, right? Let's see. There we go. It will now say YouTube channel right here. That's great. So that's pretty much how you can like customize your website. You can change the theme, change fonts, you can change colors, right? You can do all of this stuff. Now, if I go back to the homepage, what you can also do is preview your website for mobile devices. So if you're gonna get mobile visitors, you can click on mobile and you can then preview what your website looks like. So this is what our website looks like on a mobile device, which is pretty cool as well. You can pretty much click and see exactly what it looks like. Get in touch. You also see what that page looks like. So that's definitely a feature that you want to use, because a lot of web traffic is coming from mobile these days. So you want to make sure to pay attention to the mobile page as well. Now, once you're done building your website, you can click on publish in the top right corner. Right there, you can then search for a domain name. So if you simply type in, let's say, how to digital, then click search, you'll see the available domain names. So you can then go with any of these, or you can go with the subdomain, which is free, which includes Weebly branding. So it'll then be howtodigital.weebly.com. Now you can go with these, but you have to pay. So if you want to build a free website, go with the free one. And there we go. It's now going to publish your website. And there we go. We're live. Website published. So if I now paste in that URL and go to that web page, we can see that our website is now live. Now there will be Weebly branding, which is the downside if you're building free websites. I know this is really empty. I just set this up in like 2 minutes or so by using the drag and drop editor. But this is how you can go live with your website, create an account, start building the entire website. All you need to do is customize it to whatever you want, and then you're good to go. So like I said, start using all of these like features by drag and drop editing. You can add blog feed and you can do all of this, all right? It's pretty basic stuff. If you want more guides, you can click on the light icon right there and you'll find a lot of helpful articles and tutorials as well. But this is pretty much how you can set up a website and then also publish it. If this video helps you out, please consider leaving a like, and then I'll see you in the next video.